All right, thank you so much, Glenn. It is time to celebrate DVD Tuesday with Kevin Steincross.
It's a good week.
It's a good week, okay.
Three of my favorite films of 2016 are on DVD today.
Okay.
More importantly, two of them are up for Best Picture at this Sunday night's Oscar ceremony.
It's a good week.
Academy Awards this Sunday night.
All right.
So if you need to get caught up, here's your opportunity.
All right, let's go.
I'm gonna start with one that was produced by a St. Louisan, Kimberly Stewart. Mm-hmm. This is Manchester by the Sea.
I don't understand.
Which part are you having trouble with?
Well, I can't be his guardian.
Well, your brother provided for your nephew's upkeep. I think the idea was that you would relocate.
Relocate to where?
Well, if you look, it was my impression that you'd spent a lot of time here.
I swear. I'm just a backup.
As bad as his brother's death was, it was not the worst tragedy in this movie. The movie deals with unbearable grief, but it's told in such a true, such a real way. It's just outstanding. All the actors are fantastic. Casey Affleck is the favorite to win Best Actor this Sunday night. We shall see.
We shall see.
5 out of 5 reels for Manchester by the Sea. Okay, Mel Gibson, his comeback, his comeback film this year was a hit for both critics and audiences. Everybody loved it.
All right.
This one's called Hacksaw Ridge.
Well, I'm sorry, Sarge. I can't touch a gun.
You don't kill.
No, sir.
You know, quite a bit of killing does occur in war.
Private Doss does not believe in violence. Do not look to him to save you on the battlefield.
True story, Private Desmond Doss did go to war and he saved many soldiers in his battalion without ever touching a weapon.
All right.
Powerful film, true story, extremely moving. I think it's the best war film since Saving Private Ryan.
Okay.
Five out of five reels for Hacksaw Ridge as well. We're on a roll, Ken. Let's keep it going.
It's a good week. It's a good week so far.
Another film in my top 10 of last year is a film noir film that was directed by the fashion icon Tom Ford.
Ah, that's right.
This is called Nocturnal Animals.
When you love someone, you have to be careful with it. You might never get it again.
Gyllenhaal sends his ex-wife, played by Amy Adams, a manuscript for his new novel. It hits very close to home, and as she reads it, we see the terror on the page slowly begin to play out on screen. This one's gonna send chills down your spine. You already got chills, don't you?
I do.
5 out of 5 reels for Nocturnal Animals.
I can do it.
All right, those were three of the best films of last year. Now it's time to scrape the bottom of the barrel.
Hey, let's go to the bottom.
Time to dumpster dive on many levels. This one, it's a raunchy comedy that actually has a proven track record. This is Bad Santa 2.
Santa Claus gets you. The hell are you looking at me so funny for?
Sorry, Santa, I had to go.
Oh, is that you? I thought it was me.
Okay, that's funny.
That's funny.
Billy Bob Thornton is back in the beard, playing the most inappropriate Santa you've ever seen. They're kicking up the raunch another notch higher with this DVD because it is the unrated version.
Uh-oh.
This is Bad Santa 2, unrated.
Make sure your kids aren't even home.
Not for the chillins. Finally, two comedy icons together, talking about Lily Tomlin and Jane Fonda.
Oh, I love them both.
On Netflix, this is season 2 of Grace and Frankie.
It's a text from Phil. He wants to have lunch with me tomorrow. How do I look?
Like a docent at a hairspray museum.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Grace and Frankie moved in together after their husbands ran off with each other. They're like oil and water. They drive each other crazy, but somehow they make it work, and it is hilarious. You want a binge-worthy comedy? This is season 2 of Grace and Frankie on DVD today.
All right.
Lots of good stuff to choose from this week.
All right, well, we're going to go ahead, watch our highs and our lows, apparently, here on the 9 a.m. show.